All right, so I'm in Akai MPC Beats, which is the free software that they've given away. You just have to sign up with your email address. And what it is it's a free version of the full software, the MPC software. This is like a slimmed down version, kind of like a demo version, if you will. So I covered it in my previous video, did a quick review about it. But right now I want to talk about the grid, all right? And specifically of your drums, because with hip-hop drums, you know, a lot of times, you know, we just go by the grid, right? And it just, but it gives you like a robotic feel, right? So let's listen to this little drum track I got here. So, you know, you can see up on top here, I got the swing set to 75. And, you know, that classic MPC swing, you know, it's that's in there. But still, it still has that robotic feel. So the first thing I'm thinking is, how do I humanize this, right? How do you give it more of a human feel to this? One of the good features about this software, though, is that you go in here to edit and then go down here to humanize. Click that. And it gives you a few options here. I'm going to keep this the default setting here so we can see what it does. All right. So I'll hit do it. All right. So you can see they shift it. All right. You can see they move the clips around a bit. So let's just check it out and hear how it sounds. All right, so it sounds off, obviously, right? It's not really like the timing. Timing's not there because you can see like it's moved over just a bit here, a bit over here, and over here. Of course, it's way off. Now, it's one thing to have that, you know, like you want to give it more of a human feel that way, but it's not really good. Like the results aren't always going to be good. I mean, obviously, you can tweak those settings, but the point is like for me, I'd rather have more control over it, right? So I'll undo that. The main thing that I want to kind of change up is the hats, all right, because that will make a big difference with your drum loop. So not just with the swing or with the positioning on the grid, but also with the volume. So you look here, I'm on the hats here, and you can see down here the velocity. I've already set it up. I went in and I moved, you know, some of them down, right? So you see some of them are down, way down. All right, so let's listen to it again. But you can tell, especially on this one right here, you can tell where it's down. You can hear it because it's by itself. So you can really hear how it's different than the others. So as you can hear, it gives it more of a human feel, right? Because, you know, when a person is actually playing the drums, they're not just going to hit it the same velocity every single time, right? So right there, that's one trick you could do. But as far as the timing, as you can see, okay, I've got this, the time division down here on the 16th, okay? So that means you see these bars here are wider, because if I try to move the hat, look, it only skips from one bar to the next, right? So I got to bring this up all the way here, okay, to a 64th. And now you can see the smaller boxes. So it makes a difference. Now I can move it over just slightly. So I'm going to move this one, the one we're just listening to, the one with the lower volume, bring it before. Let's see how it sounds. So obviously it doesn't sound right because it's coming in too early, right? Try it one after. That's not too bad. I like that because when it comes in too early, when any kind of sound comes in too early, you can definitely hear that it's off. When it comes in a little later, it's not so bad. Because don't forget, this is just the drums here. Once you put actual, you know, some music on top of this, it's going to mask this somewhat, right? Especially depending on the volume overall of your hats. And usually the hats are just chilling in the background, so it's not really a big difference, right? But I really like this because the volume's low. It gives it more of a human feel there. So it's mainly with the hi-hats that you could do this. It's a nice little trick. Adjust the velocity and the spacing on the grid, okay? You could also do this with the snares as well. Obviously, it's going to be more noticeable with the snare. So let's listen to how it sounds here. I'll move the snare before. Let's check it out. That's not too bad with the snare before, but let's try it after. That's weird though. It's like the snare is like when it's after, it sounds, you know, a lot more noticeable. Before, it's not too bad. So I'm going to put this before. Keep it like that. And this one too, go down here to the snare so I can bring the velocity down on that one. Let's say around here. So because since I'm bringing it in early, I'm adjusting it on the grid, right? I don't like the same thing with this hat here. I want it lower so it's not as noticeable to the listener when they're hearing it. They're not going to really hear it off as much as the other snare. So let's check it out. Oh, sorry, my fault. Let's go back here. I had both snares selected, just this one selected. All right, let's try that. I mean, it's a little low. I would bring it up a little bit more maybe because the max is 127. So if I bring it down to maybe 105, 106, let's try it now. That's pretty good. I like that. I mean, it depends on your preferences. I mean, I'm just using this as an example, but I mean, you might not like it like this. It all depends on what kind of, you know, track you're making and stuff. But it just gives you some ideas of what you could do with the drums. I mean, whether it's here in MPC Beats or whether it's, you know, in some other program like Ableton or Reason or something like that, or FL Studio, of course, you know, same thing, you know, adjust the grid, move it around. Another trick you could do too is also, it depends on the samples you have, because right here, you can see on the side here, these are the samples I've loaded up from my collection. And with these ones, you know, sometimes you'll have a sample where, you know, the snare, for example, where it starts right here at the beginning. Okay, so let's go into like the wave, for example, right? So let's check the snare. All right, so what if you have a sample where at the beginning, you know, like this, for example, at the beginning, there's like a space, okay? So that's another trick you could use, because some samples are like that. You know, if you have like some drum samples, you'll have some space there. So, you know, you basically, you know, line up the snare on the grid like you normally would. It's just that when it hits the snare here, it's the sound is going to be off. So you see it on the grid lined up, but it's just that it's going to come in a little later because you got that little space at the beginning and stuff. So some samples are like that already, but you could do it yourself. Obviously, you could just take the end of here, you know, slice it and then bring it over here. You know, whether you do it in here or some other wave editor, you put it at the beginning, you could adjust that, you know. So that's another little trick. That's actually an old school trick, but here on the timeline, why not use it like this? You know, it's the same effect, really. You know, and I mean, some people argue obviously it's not really the same, because, you know, you're talking about a waveform here, but you know, on the timeline here like this, as long as you could adjust the grid to the max here, okay, 64th, and you adjust it here and then you just move it around. You know, the same thing with kicks, you know. So for example, here on the kick track, right, let's put one in here. Where did I have that before? Hold on. Let's try that, because right here, see, before, actually, I'll go back here and go back to 16th. Okay, again, if I put kick here, look, I mean, I can only put it right here. So if I put it here, let's listen to the track now. See, right there, you can really tell how robotic it sounds, right? Okay, so if I bring up the grid and I put it, let's say, here, let's check it out. See, it's got that nice, you know, pre-kick sound. And again, you can just go in here and adjust the volume right here. See, the old way I would do it on the MPC would be, I would copy this kick to another track, lower the volume there, and then just position it, you know, before the other, well, this is coming back around, so basically just position it like that. But now I could just, you know, enter the kick here, drop down the velocity here, so let's check it out. See, there you can really feel it's got that, you got more of like an MPC type of swing now you got going on and stuff. Now don't forget, I still have the swing up here. If I bring this down to 50, I don't really know. I don't think there'll be like much of a difference, but still, let's check it out. Yeah, I can hear the difference somewhat, but still, I like it like this. Let's say 75. Actually, what was the one I have on? Yeah, on my MPC, I've got it at 67. So let's check it out. So there you go. You can make a nice little loop like that, adjusting the velocity, the spacing on the grid, and it'll make a big difference with your drum track. You could do this with, you know, with other tracks that you have with some samples, right? Like for a melody. I don't advise it really, because that'll really throw everything off, kind of, because, you know, it's your main melody, right? Let's say so. This is mainly for drums. I find it's most effective. So definitely try this. I'm going to export this as a MIDI file, put it in the description. So whether you're using MPC Beats or something else, at least you'll have the MIDI pattern just for fun. You know, if you want to download it and open it up in your program, check it out and stuff, and see how it turns out for you. But, yeah, so, definitely start messing with, your grid, no matter what software you're using, whether it's, Akai's MPC Beats, or with anything else like Ableton or something, start messing with it, playing around with the grid, moving stuff around, velocity as well, and you'll be good to go. So after you hit like on this video, make sure you go to illmusic.com and check it out, sign up and get involved, and yeah, all right, so go make some beats.